WCW 79 continues here on the Superstation TBS. And as we said before, still to come, six-man tag, the Dungeon of Doom against the Four Horsemen. It'll be interesting to see how Fungo and Chris Benoit and Arn Anderson work as a unit based on the problems they've had in the past.
Well, you know, everybody's talking about the Horseman now because he's real strong, but I just think Headstrong is good for one, but Mongo McMichael, because I really believe that they are in a position right now to really dictate how the Horseman flow in 1997. And look at this. Is that a pith helmet? The pith helmet?
What helmet?
The pith helmet.
A pith helmet. P-I-T-H, is that what you call it? I don't know.
He is hunting the fox and the hound. And this is an old feud. This feud here This goes back a long time right here.
Bobby Eaton knows Squire Dave Taylor quite well. And here we go with the next matchup on WCW.
I said something about the Dungeon of Doom. You're talking about them. We're talking about the hospital. Same thing goes for them. Until the Taskmaster gets back control of his domestic situation and gets back in order with that Dungeon of Doom, they were really on the verge of going ahead, and they could destroy the NWO, I think, just that group of guys right there. But they're in disarray, so I'm anxious to see how they come out of this thing tonight.
What a shock it was this past Monday. We will show you the footage later on of the Macho Man Randy Savage coming out of the stands and basically stopped Nitro, stopped the proceedings, attacked everyone. It took Sting to rappel from the top of the United Center to really take Savage away from the ring. And I think it's very obvious. You will see the footage. You've heard Eric Bischoff.
Yeah.
Based on Rowdy Roddy Piper and what he did to Hollywood Hulk Hogan and Starrcade, it's going to be very tough for people who can beat Hogan to come into WCW because Bischoff is protecting his back.
Well, that's true. And you know, like you say, the rule of all, but Piper proved it could be done. And I know he's sitting out there recuperating, getting himself together. And once again, kudos to Roddy Piper. And bottom line now, the Macho Man Randy Savage trying to make a statement. Eric Bischoff trying to cut him off. Only time will tell. That uppercut nearly took his noggin off. That was a tater. I mean, he laid that one in.
And for the Macho Man Randy Savage, we have no idea if he is here tonight, what he will be doing next, if he will align himself with Sting. So many questions need to be answered. And then again, we don't know even if Sting's appearance was on behalf of the New World Order or not the other night. You can decide for yourself as we will show you that footage later on in this two-hour telecast of WCW Saturday night on this Super Bowl weekend. And what a place to be here in Green Bay right before the Super Bowl.
Us and about 10,000 people stayed here. Everybody else in this town went down to New Orleans, you know what I mean? But I guarantee you, what an atmosphere it is. And what a reception we have for WCW right here on this Saturday night. And Bobby is trying to take out all his frustration right here.
In one match, it
on
looks
the
like.
Squad. Yes. Yeah.
He is pounding away.
Yes. Knocking him right there.
One,
too close to
two,
the
three.
Well, you know
David
what?
Taylor got the win that time.
Yeah, but I think he used the rope.
I think maybe you're right. Squire David Taylor comes away with a win over Bobby Eaton here on Saturday night. And now let's go to Chris Cruz for 1-800-COLLECT with this week's Road Report.
Thanks, Tony. Nice to be with you and Dusty, the American Dream, Rhodes, here on WCW Saturday night. Tonight, I am in Veterans Memorial Auditorium in Des Moines, Iowa. This Monday night, it's January 27th, live Monday Nitro, local bell time, 6:30. Tickets available at the Veterans Memorial Auditorium box office and at all Ticketmaster outlets for Monday Nitro. That's the 1-800-COLLECT Road Report. I'm Chris Cruz in Des Moines, Iowa for 1-800-COLLECT.